Responsive projects are known that they can fit any screen sizes, such as desktop, tablet, or mobile. To create a responsive project, click Active Presenter, and select Responsive Project. Or you can convert from a normal project to a responsive one. Select the layouts you want to add. In responsive projects, Active Presenter uses two types of object size and position units, which are pixels and percentages. When you convert an existing project to a responsive one, you should consider which type of units. Because the unit you choose decides how the object's position and size change in different layouts. Refer to How to Manage Objects in Responsive Projects video for information. You can also choose to scale the content in width, height, or both dimensions. The Maintain Aspect Ratio option allows you to maintain the height to width ratio of the slide size, and scale the contents. Normally, a responsive project has 5 types of default layouts like this. However, these layout sizes are not the device viewport sizes. Therefore, Active Presenter makes it possible to add a new layout with custom size. You can freely rename the existing layouts to more meaningful names. Sometimes, you no longer need any layout, you can select it and remove. Besides, you can change the size of the default layouts. To change the layout width, drag this handle. Make sure that the new width must be in the width range of the currently selected layout. For example, the selected layout now is desktop, so you are just allowed to drag the handle within the orange width range. To change the layout height, in the Layout Height section of the Slide Properties tab, tick this checkbox and enter a value here. Or you can drag the handle on the canvas. The slide height is usually equal to the layout height, but you can increase or decrease it if necessary. In case that the slide height is bigger than the device layout height, users can view the contents beyond the layout by scrolling the bar on their devices. That's it. Thank you for watching.